All Georgia 4-H programs and half of the Cooperative Extension County offices would have been eliminated under a State Board of Regents proposal to cut an additional $300 million from the University System of Georgia's fiscal year 2011 budget. That was requested by state lawmakers. Rick Trepto reports that reaction came quickly across the state.
No budget cuts! No budget cuts! No budget cuts!
The day after the University System of Georgia's proposed cuts were released, students took to the state capitol steps to fight for the investment in their education and futures. Inside the capitol, there have been many budget hearings, each one trying to find money to bring the budget total down. There was a news conference following a Senate Higher Education Committee hearing with Chancellor Earl Davis and University of Georgia President Dr. Michael Adams. The $14.4 million in proposed reductions to the UGA's College of Agriculture and Environmental Sciences would slash major services and facilities. All Georgia 4-H programs, including 116 positions, would be eliminated. One half of the UGA's county offices would close. Farmers and farm families, especially in rural areas, rely on these agents for new crop production and livestock information and techniques. The 4-H children build close ties with specialists that keep them active in agriculture. Other cuts include the Archway Partnership Program. UGA support for the Griffin Teaching Program would stop. State support for the UGA Veterinary Teaching Hospital would be reduced, and four research centers would close. The C.M. Stripling Irrigation Park in Camilla, the Vidalia Onion and Vegetable Research Center in Reidsville, the Atopogus Research Farm, which does major plant disease and weed research, and the Georgia Mountain Research Farm in Blairsville.
Our agriculture remains an important part throughout the state. We're going to continue to support that. But no, I'm not surprised that any group that we had to put on that $60 million list is concerned about that, because every single one of them has constituencies. But don't lose sight of the fact there are over $20 million in pure academic cuts on that list. And with all due respect, that's what everybody in the state needs to be most concerned about, because that's the future of this state. That's the research potential, it's the creativity, and it's what we're all trying to produce for the state.
Agriculture, despite the nightmarish scenarios, has widespread support in both the House and Senate.
Between forestry and agriculture, it's the two largest economic income producers in the state of Georgia. We certainly don't want to jeopardize any of those programs.
They're just outrageous cuts, and the elimination of 4-H, that's not going to happen. The closing down of experiment stations, we're not going to allow that to happen. But we're going to have to make some cuts. So everybody's going to have to suffer a little bit. We can't just stop research. It's an ongoing effort.
Also slated for closure under the land-grant college's cuts is the Rock Eagle 4-H Center in Putnam County. It was opened in 1955. It provides a good family environment, and the facilities have all been well maintained.
I've worked very hard to support 4-H. Representative Smith and I worked together to raise money. We just built a great new dining hall at Rock Eagle. I've raised a lot of private money, or helped raise it.
I spent four summers at Rock Eagle. Those are memories that I'll always cherish. And it's meant so much to so many youth throughout their lifetime. And 4-H is just not going to go away.
The legislators say any cuts in the budget will be hard. The Georgia General Assembly must, under state law, have a balanced budget by adjournment. So cutbacks and/or creating new revenue sources to help fund the ag programs and facilities are being considered. I'm Rick Trepto for the Georgia Farm Monitor.
We caught up with Georgia Farm Bureau President Zippy Duval at a Bleckley County tailgate breakfast. That's a series of informal meetings and lunches he has with farmers from around the state on a regular basis to get their views on issues. Asked about the firestorm over cuts to the state's ag education programs, Duval said, to echo Governor Sonny Perdue's comments on the proposed ag cuts, "Not on my watch." He said Georgia Farm Bureau's policy supports full funding of the different agricultural programs at the university, the Ag Research Stations, and the College of Agriculture. And he said those programs must be funded.
Who would think anyone would have an idea of destroying a program that's in the top five of all the nation in 4-H and Extension Service? Who would ever think anybody would put forth that idea? You know, I would agree with the governor, not on our watch, not without a huge fight. We're very big supporters of the Extension 4-H research. We can't continue to move forward in Georgia in agriculture without them. We expect them to be there. We need them, and we're going to make sure that we fight to keep them that way.
State Senate Agriculture Committee Chairman John Bullock said that the university system is bluffing on cutting the popular farm programs, as he says agencies do at budget time occasionally. Georgia House Speaker David Ralston weighed in, responding to all the headlines of impending calamity, saying that he does not believe any cuts will be as bad as some fear.